evening, I went to see if I could find the photographer Claudia, who took the famous picture of Che Guevara. Tell me how you took the picture.
Well, you remember I told you I was at the beginning of the revolution in the 1958. I began to make picture at the street and the revolution, what happened, the people in the street. Fidel Castro speaking. And, well, it was the 1959, and we buy an arm in Belgium to defend the revolution. A French ship arrived to Havana with arm, and then when the ship was discharged in the harbor of Havana, some artifact of perhaps put by the CIA made a big explosion of the ship.
El sabotaje y la guerra. Manos cayeron en la explosión del vapor francés La Cubre.
They killed 136 persons. And the other day, 6th of March of 1959, it was a funeral at 2 blocks in front of the Havana cemetery, Havana. And Fidel Castro speak. And all the people of the government, the president, Fidel Castro, Che Guevara, all the important people of the government was at the tribune. I was in front of the tribune, and Che Guevara, you cannot see because was behind the people in front. And I passed my camera shooting all the people in the tribune. And then in an unexpected moment, Che Guevara appeared in front of the tribune, and he looked with this face to all the souls and people that was in the street. And I take one picture. I charged my camera, I put in vertical and take another picture. I took and he go. It was only 20 or 30 seconds. And is that the reason that this picture that has been famous in all the world today is a picture of casuality. It was not a thinking picture by my intellectual premonition, nothing like that. It was a pack, two pictures and no more. And then I print the picture that night and I take it to the newspaper I work at. Fidel Castro speaking, many people important in the Tribune. Sartre and Simone de Beauvoir, the French intellectual, was at the Tribune. Here, Fidel Castro. And I made the picture of Che Guevara too. But they don't publish. Then, this picture was, nobody know, only four or five friends of mine that I have given, but nobody know this picture in Cuba. But an Italian publisher named Feltrinelli that I have given this picture 4 months before Che Guevara died in Bolivia, make a poster, a big poster, 1 meter by 70 centimeters. He published in Italy and the picture made an explosion in the world. And then is the history of the most famous picture of the history of photography, how they say in a book, in an American book.
Tell me why you would never leave Cuba.
Because we have the best revolution in the world today. The most human being. Because it's my land, I'm born here, I have my mother here, my father is died here, and we have a beautiful sun, a blue sky all the year, and I love it, this country. I understand very well what Fidel, what to do with a society. And I appreciate, I try to do the best thing I can do to help. But you are a doctor, you know how good is the medicine in Cuba for poor people, for everybody. We have many things to appreciate of the government. We are not a perfect society, I know, but I hate the perfect. We have something that are not good, other good, but a 90% of the things we do to government a country are good.
Now tell me what you like taking photographs of now.
To photograph now?
Yes.
Well, what I love it all my life is to photograph beautiful women. And now again, yes. When I began in photography, I was advertising photography and fashion. I love fashion photography. But in the same way, I love the revolution when they arrived to Cuba. In the same way, I love the underwater world. And I have to do all my life what I love. In this way, I has worked all my life. For me, it has not been a work, it's a pleasure to do. Now I am making exposition in Cuba and outside in Cuba about my famous picture.
Yeah.
It's good for me because it gives me a chance to travel, to know other country, and to show something about the Cuban Revolution that other people don't publish.
Yeah.